Arterial blood pressure. When the left ventricle ejects blood into the aorta, the aortic pressure rises. The maximal aortic pressure following ejection is termed the systolic pressure. As the ventricle is relaxing and refilling, the pressure in the aorta falls. The lowest pressure in the aorta, which occurs just before the ventricle ejects blood into the aorta, is termed the diastolic pressure. When blood pressure is measured using a sphygmomanometer, the upper value is the systolic pressure and the lower value is the diastolic pressure. Normal systolic pressure is less than 120 mm of Hg, and normal diastolic pressure is less than 80 mm of Hg. The difference between the systolic and diastolic pressures is the aortic pulse pressure, which typically ranges between 40 to 50 mm of Hg. The mean aortic pressure is the average pressure during the aortic pulse cycle. When the arterial pressure is measured using a sphygmomanometer, that is, the blood pressure cuff on the upper arm, the systolic and diastolic pressures that are measured represent the pressure within the brachial artery, which is slightly different than the pressure found in the aorta or the pressure found in other distributing arteries. As the aortic pressure pulse travels down the aorta and into distributing arteries, these are characteristic changes in the systolic and diastolic pressure, as well as in the mean pressure. The systolic pressure rises and the diastolic pressure falls. Therefore, the pulse pressure increases as the pulse pressure travels away from the aorta. This occurs because of reflective waves from vessel branching and from decreased arterial compliance as the pressure pulse travels from the aorta into systemic arteries. There is only a small decline in mean arterial pressure as the pressure pulse travels down distributing arteries due to the relatively low resistance of large distributing arteries.